whole notion of a Western man coming to a foreign country to find a spark with someone in a week and then hopefully marry them 6 months later?
I don't know. I suppose if you believe in Cinderella, it's probably fine. But it's a fairy tale.
So what was your experience like working for the agency?
Very unethical. Most of the girls in the database didn't have any contact details, no telephone number, no email.
So they're fakes?
Basically, yeah. But they then suggest, maybe five or six other ladies, that they suggest to almost every client.
Really?
Yeah.
And are they almost escorts, so they just kind of go on the date?
Basically, they're paid to go on the date, and then they get a free meal from a client, and yeah, it's not very nice.
So the men basically just need to be aware of the fact that a lot of these women, firstly, aren't looking for husbands. Secondly, they're probably going to try and rob them. And thirdly, the men should expect to maybe get some sex if they're lucky enough to get an undercover prostitute.
Exactly.
I love ping pong. In fact, if you ever come to the United States, I'll buy a ping pong table. So you can come play ping pong at my house.
Oh, that's very nice.
Oh, seriously?
There are no, you know, closer place to here than
no, you have
to go to the United States.
You have to go to the US.
Irina is a 26-year-old interior designer, living on her own here in town. After an hour of chatting, I'm keen to catch up with them to see if the feeling is mutual.
Irina, is there a spark between you two?
What?
Is there a nice spark between you two?
Sure.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Do you really like him?
Physically, maybe not, but he's a nice kind of person, you know, I like talking to him. So we'll see what...
He's really into you.
Really? You think so?
You got this look in your eye, you're like, yeah, whatever, you know, who cares?
It's a very nice way to act with guys.
But how serious are you? How serious are you about coming here and finding a boyfriend?
I am serious.
Really serious?
Sometimes you say you can't fire this stuff, no?
Dave is a textile worker from the Rosendale Valley. He's been going out with 25-year-old Alexandra since she contacted him online 3 years ago. And they're engaged.
There's a big age difference between Alexandra and myself, and I think that people perceive that as a problem. You could sort of sense, you know, oh, dirty old, you know, sort of, that sort of thing, you know.
Alexandra has just graduated with a degree in civil law, as well as being a qualified nurse. And for the past 2.5 years, while she's been studying, Dave's been sending her £60 a week, more than the average Russian wage.
She doesn't work. Her parents don't really have any money. It's hard for her, you know.
Dave's only met up with Alexandra 5 times in Russia, and she's never been to Britain. But today, Alexandra's giving up her law career to move over and start a new life with Dave in the village of Waterford, population 1,200.
You know, I thought, Russia. I said, you know, basically, you're crazy.
I thought, Russia? I thought we was English women. Why'd you have to go so far?
Not very happy about the supporting bit. My dad's not a millionaire. You know, what's going on here? Why is my dad sending the money?
She's here. Appreciate, darling. OK? Mm-hmm. OK? Nice flight.
Oh.
No, yeah. It's Anna. This is sister-in-law Angela, you know.
I don't know how much English you can speak. I don't know how they communicate, to be quite honest with you. I've never thought of asking them.
I personally don't understand how you can love somebody you can't speak to.
Ah.
It's just a bit strange seeing your dad with somebody so young.
Dave had been single for 7 years before meeting Alexandra, and he spent their whole relationship lobbying for her to come and live with him.
Say hello, Alexandra. Yeah, it's nice to have her here. Yeah, great.
But now she's here, will they tie the knot, or will Alexandra decide that British life's not for her?
Okay.
Запущено состояние. Бардак и грязь. Ой, ну прежде всего, конечно, вот это вот все хотелось бы починить. Там воду, чтобы все это не текло, и вот это вот все закрыть. Убрать этот ужасный зеленый цвет.
Yeah, I'm gonna look at this toilet. Looks like it's slipped out. It's amazing how much a little bit of water can make so much damage.
Dave has built a bed for him and Alexandra, but hasn't got a mattress yet. As a temporary measure, they're sleeping on two single mattresses on the floor.
Тут, понимаю, Дэйв тут работает. Рабочий, наверное, его, это рабочая комната, видимо, да? Вот, ну, везде тоже думаю, что здесь тоже нужно навести порядок, прибраться. Кто это будет делать? Дэйв, наверное.
А?
6 месяцев здесь это 100% нет. Посмотрю, как он живет. Ближе познакомиться с традициями, с обычаями. Это же тоже очень важно. У нас очень большая разница. Культуры совершенно разные. Как-то вот хотелось бы, конечно, это все сперва посмотреть.
But Alexandra has already come to some important conclusions about her stay in Britain and about the future of her relationship.
Мы подумаем, мы еще подумаем. Я думаю, ему тоже есть над чем подумать. Дело серьезное. Возможно, и не конец вовсе. Вполне возможно. Просто я вернусь в Россию однозначно. Когда я шла на интервью в посольство получать визу, честно сказать, у меня была маленькая надежда, что мне ее не дадут. Почему-то не горело пламенным желанием прям. Конечно же, я его люблю. Любовь бывает разная. Я его очень уважаю. У всех есть недостатки. Но ответить прямо на вопрос, люблю я его или нет, я сейчас не могу.
Alexandra has been in the UK for 4 weeks. And although her visa allows her to stay up to 6 months, she's decided to leave Britain.
Are you excited, Alexandra?
Oh, really excited. Думаю, что ждала этого дня с того момента, как приземлилась в Англии. Ура!
Alexandra and Dave haven't split up, but she hasn't booked a return flight back to the UK.
Я не знаю, что будет после того, как я уеду. Сейчас я не могу сказать ни да, ни нет просто.
Dave has been supporting Alexandra financially.
God forbid, if it did all end tomorrow, then I wouldn't have any regrets. I certainly wouldn't turn and say, well, you know, I've supported you for the last 3 years and this is what you do.